Well, it's my pleasure to introduce you to Sub-Lieutenant Shivangi. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And why am I congratulating her? She is the first woman pilot of Indian Navy. And not just that, it's interesting. You have been trained by one of the oldest naval squadrons, 550. It's called Flying Machine? Flying Fish.
Right.
All right, so a lot of history around you.
Yeah.
How are you feeling about this?
Well, I won't be able to, you know, describe my feelings in words. It was a great experience. My parents were also here, so altogether it was a very special moment for me. I had always wanted these wings here, so finally I've got it, so it's an entirely different feeling.
Well, absolutely a very proud moment. We witnessed her getting the wings today. You know, before I go on to your training and about all that you had to do during your training, personally, it's quite an achievement for you. You come from a family where there have not been any defense personnel in your family. I spoke to your father, who's very emotional, very overwhelmed, if I can say correctly, that here's my daughter who's done what she has. Tell us a little about your personal journey.
Well, I come from Muzaffarpur, Bihar, which is a small town in Bihar, and I've not seen many people around me who were there. In fact, I've not seen anyone in my family who's there in defense. So for me, you know, when I went to college, I joined something which is not very conventional for a girl to do. I joined mechanical engineering. So that time also I thought that maybe my parents will mind, but they were in fact very supportive. And after my graduation, in my fourth year of graduation, when I saw you know, small video about Navy, which was done by a naval officer, they had come for UES entry, university entry scheme. So, that time I decided to join Navy, and I told my parents, okay, I want to join Defense Forces now. So they were in fact very, you know, they were very excited because that was something new for them also. They had not seen somebody joining Defense Forces in our family. My grandfather, he was a farmer, so it is a completely different, you know, line to go to. So, but they were all very supportive. They were like, okay, go ahead. We also want to see what all happens. So I would say because of their support and, you know, all my friends, colleagues, everyone, I'm here.
Well, you know, I have to ask you this. When did you get to know that you would become the first woman pilot for the Indian Navy?
Well, it was about 2 weeks back because...
It's not long ago. So all through your training period, you did not know this.
No.
How long in your training period have you been?
1 year of flying training, and in Navy I've been since last 1.5 years.
So all this while she did not know that she would become the first pilot for Indian Navy. Now, let me tell you why are we here. This is the Dornier aircraft, and this is the aircraft that Sub-Lieutenant Shivangi has been trained to be in charge of. So you are being trained, and you are trained to be part of maritime reconnaissance. How do you see this?
Well, I'm not fully operational on this aircraft as of now. I'll be doing my stage 3 training here in 550 itself, which is Dornier operational flying training, which will be starting from 13th of January. In that, we'll be taught about different missions. We go for armament sorties, we go for maritime reconnaissance missions, and we are taught about everything else. Whatever mission Navy is, you know, Navy undertakes, we are taught about everything. So I'm looking forward to that. To my, you know, starting of my third stage of training.
And now we are inside the cockpit of the Dronia, and here we have Sub-Lieutenant Shivangi, who is in the process of doing her checks. She's taking us through what exactly is happening in the cockpit. She'll not be able to explain everything because I won't understand everything. But Sub-Lieutenant Shivangi, you know, as you train, as you become the first woman to take charge of a Dornier in the Navy as a woman, what has it been, the whole process of training for you? Were there any briefs which were given to you? What was it?
We had training in 3 stages. So our first stage was your basic induction in the Indian Navy. So you are sent to Erimala, and you are trained for a basic naval orientation course. So that is about 6 months, and that is all physical training. It's they'll not tell you anything about flying. after your like their aim is to mold you into an officer first, and after your 6 months of training, they'll send you to do basic ground training, training for flying. That happens in Safna, School for Naval Airmen, which is here. So after that, we were sent to Air Force Academy, Dondigal, where we did our first stage of flying training on Pilatus. And since it was Air Force environment, it's not very uncommon in Air Force. They have a lot of women pilots already. So there I feel there's no difference. Everyone was treated equally. And after our first stage of training, I've come here in 550. So my commanding officer, Captain Jeetu George, he was very, first day in my squadron, he had called me for an interview and he told me, you should not feel like you're the only one, pilot, woman trainee. Because if you start thinking that way, then, you'll never be able to gel up with everyone. You should feel like a trainee, you should behave like a trainee and... take whatever it comes and just do your best. And he also told me that this aircraft, it doesn't know the gender of pilot who's flying. He just know that a pilot is flying the aircraft. So if you do everything correctly, it will all fall into place. If you're not doing your not following your procedures correctly, then someday it will you'll crash or something adverse will happen.
All right. So tell me something. You're going to be part of the maritime reconnaissance team for women who are looking at the defense services. Many of them asking, why should we join the defense services? Permanent commission is an issue in combative roles and several such things. So how do you see this? What do you want to tell young women who aspire to get into the defense services?
See, the kind of lifestyle that you see in defense, the kind of discipline they follow and the way they carry themselves, it's very different from, people in civil world. And that depends on that person. Suppose some people would want this lifestyle, some people they would not want. But for them who want to join, I would say just don't think too much. If you have thought of joining defense, then please do your best, do your part and, join, enjoy the life. It's wonderful life in defense, and you will feel like you're doing something directly for the, everyone is doing their part for the country, but you'll feel like you're actually serving your nation, and it's a great feeling.
Great. Is this a combative role?
It's not really a combative role, because we are not going to attack someone. We'll be in case there is a somebody tells that there is a we have to rescue someone in sea, then we'll go rescue him or her. It's not really a combat role, but we do have gun ports. We do fire if required in on ships. We can fire, so like that it is, but not purely combat.
Right. Also, so now you're getting trained with a Dornier. What next? What's your next aim?
My next phase is Dornier operational flying training, which will be, I'll be fully conversed with the all the operations that Navy undertakes. So I'll be able to carry them out. I'll be appointed as a staff officer. I'll be going with the crew who is going for maritime reconnaissance missions. Many a times they are sent to identify vessels from other countries. So all those things, and I'll be part of that. And once I'm done that, I have gained enough experience on Dornier. I would like to convert to PATI.
Oh, well, that's great. That's already an aim. For many women who are watching us, for many men who are watching us, you definitely are an inspiration, and all the very best to you. What's the last words that you want to leave us with?
Well, if you have decided something, if you have decided to do something, then please go ahead with it. Don't think about what others think. You just follow what you want to do and just give your best, and you will achieve it.
Well, all the very best, ma'am. Thank you so much.